Hi, I'm Frederick. My handle is Richba5tard. I'm from Belgium and I'm the founder of HWBOT. My education is computer programmer. I did it from 2000 to 2004, one year longer than I was supposed to do, but it turned out okay. The thing that got me into overclocking was when my computer broke, I got a free, what was its name? One of the very first GeForce cards. I overclocked it with a Peltier element, so a tech. With very do-it-yourself water cooling, was able to push it to almost twice the speed that it was supposed to run, and it was just fast enough to run, I think, World of Warcraft or something. No, not World of Warcraft, the Warcraft 3 game. Yeah, the Warcraft 3 game. And that was, it was a great moment for me because without overclocking, I was not able to run the game, and with overclocking, it just ran. Well, when I started overclocking, the forums were very popular and people shared their scores to boast that their PC was running much faster than they were supposed to. But I found it a real pity that you could not compare your scores against people from other forums. So I started writing a bot that gathered all the scores from all the overclocking forums and posted a global ranking. So on your own forum you could see, okay, my score is good in my local forum, but there are other fora which are even faster scores, so you could compare it globally. If I compare today, overclocking of today, with overclocking of the good old days, it used to be more about getting more performance from your PC for less money, and now it's a little bit more to get a little bit prestige, a bit more sponsorship related. Okay, it is the side effects of being a more professional sport. But I hope the days that it was a hobby for a lot of people will come back a little bit. Looking forward, I hope that Intel and AMD will reintroduce a lot of low-end processors which allow full overclocking capabilities and are comparable when overclocked with the performance of a high-end processor. So it again has an economical reason to overclock and not just for show. Well, we're definitely trying to make overclocking as an esport happen with the new OSA esports site. I think it's the next step in professional overclocking and getting all the manufacturers on board on one single platform. To have all the official competitions so you can everyone can compare globally and compete globally against each other. For new overclockers, my advice would be to get a cheap, well overclockable processor and video card and just have a lot of fun to see how much you can push it from the factory defaults and see how far you go. And compare against other people from your country or from everyone globally to see how far that you can push yourself and your system. It's my first time in Taipei and I love it here. The enthusiasm for computer hardware is nowhere bigger than here. I love it that you have entire streets full of computer hardware with the latest and greatest gadgets and motherboards and video cards. The people here are really hardware enthusiasts.